Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Here we are for a Legacy 8-man with the deck that I played at the last Grand Prix. I'm on the draw. My hand is great. I choose not to mulligan. Probably one of the best draws I can get, given that it has a Delver and some nice action. Opponent has Polluted Delta into Underground Sea. Probably playing Storm, if I had to guess. Ooh, Inquisition. I mean, I have to let it resolve, but don't know exactly what he's playing. Probably some bug deck. Takes the Delver. It's a good play by him. Ponder. My options are cast land, or play land, cast Ponder, or wasteland my opponent. It's a tough decision, but I think I'm going to go with the wasteland, given that if I don't do that, my opponent will be able to play a second land and play multiple things. Okay. Also, I thought that because he played turn one Inquisition, it was unlikely that he had a Deathrite Shaman in his hand, and if the best thing that he can do is land go, then being able to wasteland him is, like, pretty good for me. These cards are fine, but I think I'm going to shuffle. The Spell Pierce is bad. Can't cast the Geist of St. Draft, so this looks like a shuffle to me. Plus, also, if I hit another wasteland, it's just very good for me. So I'm going to try to do that. And the Spell Pierce that was in there is just, like, bad card. Also, with Batterskull in my hand, I'd like to hit Brainstorm at some point to get rid of it. My opponent's playing an Esper deck. Alright. Have a lot of options here. I would like to cast Ponder, but I'm unsure whether or not I should play my land first. Could pay for a daze, be able to spell pierce some, like a spell pierce of his. Also, if I don't play the land, then I could ponder into a wasteland. I think I'm going to play it because it lets me have spell pierce up. Yeah, definitely going to spell pierce that. There's just a lot of value in that. Because I have two spell pierces in my hand, the second one's a little redundant, and the ponder resolving is great for me. Land, Stoneforge, and yeah, these are keepers. But I'm going to leave the Stoneforge on top of my library so it does not get thought seized. Kept the Arid Mesa because it's just better than a Tundra. It can turn into a Volcanic if that gets wastelanded. Also, if I happen to draw Brainstorm later in the game, I get to go, like, fetch shuffle, or Brainstorm shuffle, I mean. It's probably going to be a Lingering Souls, which, you know, Snapcaster, quite good here. I'll let it resolve, and then I'll just daze the Inquisition, and then I'll play land, Stoneforge Mystic. Daze that. Could have just Force of Willed the Snapcaster, but Daze is not getting any better, so. And there's the Jit. Game is going quite well for me. Brainstorm is absurdly powerful card. Nothing I can do about it. Just an island, though. That's nice. I think my opponent probably has the card Vendilion Click in his hand, just given the way he's playing. That's a very good draw. I'm just going to pass because now I can have Force of Will and Spell Pierce up. As expected, I will Force of Will at removing the Delver. And I'm just going to put in Batterskull because I don't want my opponent to respond to me activating Stoneforge Mystic by casting another Vendilion Click, which would result in Batterskull going onto the bottom of my library. That's like always a really good trick against Stoneforge Mystic is you respond. Like, let's say I had no cards in my hand, I go Stoneforge, get Batterskull, I activate, and then he responds and Vendilion Clicks away Batterskull. Also, I'm highly satisfied with my decision to leave Spell Pierce in my hand instead of Delver for this exact situation. Get out of here. Hopefully I draw Wasteland so I can go Jit Equip. Force of Will, that's not going to do it. Let's give you a beatdown. And then pass turn. I guess I should have put Jit into play for the same Vendilion Click reasons I previously mentioned. He has Jit now. I suppose I can allow that to resolve. It's not that bad for me. Let's put my GTA into play. Excellent. Ponder's great. What to do with it, though? I think I just keep Force of Will up. Though, yeah. So I could try to hit, like, a Lightning Bolt, but then I won't be able to equip Jit this turn. I could try to get a Wasteland for Creeping Tar Pit. Not that great. Tough decision. Problem is, if I attack with my Germ, he can get two Jit counters, give the Germ -2/-2 before my Jit gets counters, and then I have just a Stoneforge Mystic, so I'm at risk of losing to like Plow or Jace. But I honestly just don't think that's going to happen. For whatever reason, I just don't think that's going to be the outcome of the game. So I'm just going to go for it. He blocks. Good play. Hope my opponent doesn't have Supreme Verdict. That would suck. Okay, -1, and presumably -1 again. Which, you know, that happens. There's nothing we can do about that. Yep, Jace. My Force of Will. Don't think he has Force Blue card in his hand. And he doesn't. Luckily. Force of Will, that's fine. I say attack, let's go +2/+2, and +2/+2. So take 8 damages, and pass the turn. Hopefully he doesn't have a third Jace, that would be really problematic. It is fetching. Black white, yeah. What in the world is this? Probably Lingering Souls. But you never know. Liliana? Puke. Oh, that's bad for me. Yep, I sacrificed my Derm. I'm going to return Batter Skull to my hand, so I can eventually recast it. Also, if I drop Brainstorm, it's really good for me. Stoneforge Mystic. Well, I'm just going to cast it. Doesn't do anything, but put a body into play. And there's nothing in here. That's another reason to be putting Batter Skull into my hand, in case I draw Mystic. Hopefully my opponent doesn't have a Thoughtseize. Or a Swords to Plowshares. What in the world? There's a lot of mana. Oh, his own Batter Skull. Okay, okay. That I can beat. I think I can beat that. He's choosing not to plus one Liliana, at least not just yet. And there it is. I would really like to draw Swords to Plowshares. That's the best card I can draw. Tundra does almost nothing. What to do? Ah, man, we're in a pickle here. Could equip Stoneforge, attack Liliana. It's fine, but then he just lets it happen, puts Jit on Batterskull, and then we're in trouble. I sort of want to say, use Stoneforge Mystic to put Batterskull into play, land, equip Batterskull, but then he minus twos Liliana, I lose Stoneforge? I guess that's not the end of the world. And there's the Batter Dad. And let's equip. Really needs to draw, like, Brainstorm, Lightning Bolt. Also, I need to hope he doesn't draw anything. I drew nothing, so that's good. This is a really interesting game. Activates the Tar Pit. Probably is going to put Jin on it. And he does. I'm going to kill it with my Jit. Seems like my best move. Minus one, minus one. And let's do that one more time. Minus one, minus one. Now I have a tough decision as to what to sacrifice when he does this Liliana move. Think it's the Stoneforge, but I really, obviously losing that's gonna suck. Oh, man. Thing is, if I were to draw a land, it's really good for me to have Stoneforge Mystic, because I can pick up Batterskull, put it back into play, and it's great. But also, I save a lot of mana having Jit and Batterskull equipped to the same creature. Like, if my top card is, like, Swords to Plowshares exactly, it's really, really good for me. I think I'm going to sacrifice Stoneforge Mystic. Wow, Swords to Plowshares. We did it, boys. We are right in the driver's seat. Hopefully no Liliana for my opponent. Or Jace. Yep. Wow. That was really fortunate. Had some really nice top decks in a row, and our opponent had some not very good draws in a row. Okay. I saw Batterskull. My opponent has Stoneforge Mystic in his deck. Grimlovmancer is great. Wear and Tear is great. Also, did I see Force of Will? Don't think so. I saw Spell Pierce. Brainstorm. Snapcaster. Yeah. These are probably great. Geist seems okay. I think Force of Will is probably pretty bad, and Spell Pierce is probably pretty bad on the draw. Does this sideboarding strategy make sense? I think I probably want some Force of Will. I guess I don't have that many blue cards. I have 4, 8, 12, 16, 17, 18, 19. That is low. I do agree that it's low. Cage is, like, okay against Snapcaster and Lingering Souls, but it's probably in such low numbers that I shouldn't bother. I think I'll put in Spell Pierce. Maybe more Spell Pierces because they're so good against Liliana and Jace. Could cut some Dazes. Like, add, like, all my Spell Pierce. And have, like, one Daze only. Is Geist good? What's better, Geist or Daze? I have to Geist just to have more threats. Only one Daze. Don't know how I feel about that. It's pretty bad on the draw. Yeah, I'll do this, I think. Literally every card in my deck costs one mana. That is where I like to be.